Here we're asked to solve another rational equation. We'll begin by factoring the denominator. Here, x squared factors x times x. We'll use 1 and 3. 1 and 3 add up to negative 2 if we have x minus 3 times x plus 1. Negative 3 times positive 1 is negative 3. Negative 3x plus 1x is negative 2x. Once we have it factored, we then make note of the restrictions. The restrictions here by inspection we can see are negative 1 and 3. Once we make note of the restrictions, we then multiply both sides by the LCD. In this case, the LCD is x minus 3 times x plus 1. Multiplying both sides of the LCD and then distributing is equivalent to multiplying all the terms by the LCD. In this case, we can see x plus 1 will cancel, and we'll be left with x minus 3 plus. Here, x minus 3 will cancel, leaving us with x times x plus 1 equals x minus 3 cancels and x plus 1 cancels, leaving us with 4x. Multiplying both sides by the LCD clears the fractions. We then solve the resulting equation. In this case, when we distribute here, we'll have x squared plus x. We can see this is quadratic. The goal is to obtain standard form. Let's write x squared here, x plus x plus 2x minus 3 equals 4x. And then subtracting 4x, we then obtain standard form. We have x squared, 2x minus 4x is minus 2x, minus 3 equals 0. Next, we factor. Here, x times x, we'll use 1 and 3. In this case, x minus 3 times x plus 1. Negative 3 times positive 1 is negative 3 again, and the middle term adds up to negative 2. So this is factored correctly. So we next set each factor equal to 0. Adding 3 to both sides, we have x equals 3. Subtracting 1 to both sides, we have then x equals negative 1. Now notice, x equals 3 is a restriction. If we evaluate in the original, we get 0 in the denominator. Also, negative 1 is a restriction. So both our possible solutions are extraneous. And if both the solutions are extraneous, then the original equation has no solution.